يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه. On that day on which some of the faces will be whitened and brightened and some of the faces will be blackened. فأما الذين اسودت وجوههم, people whose faces will be blackened, أكفرتم بعد إيمانكم, they will be the people who committed kufr after iman. It will be said to them, did you revert to kufr after accepting Islam and iman? فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكفرون. Now taste this azab, this punishment, this torment because of what you had been doing and the kufr that you committed. وأما الذين ابيضت وجوههم, and those whose faces will be brightened, ففي رحمة الله, they will be in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, هم فيها خالدون, or they will, and they will dwell in that mercy forever. تلك آيات الله نتلوها عليك بالحق. These are the آيات of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala which we are reciting unto you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بالحق, with truth, with a purpose. وَمَنْ لَاهُ يُرِيدُ ظُلْمًا لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And Allah doesn't intend ظلم, intend injustice towards all the worlds. وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And to Allah belongs everything that is in the heavens and that is on the earth. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأُمُورِ. And all the matters will finally be returned towards him, that is for the final judgment. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. O Muslims, now you have become the best ummah that has been created, that has been raised for the people, for the humanity at large. This ayah, we can say, is the replica of the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah. كَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. This is how we have made you the best ummah, the middle ummah, so that you become witnesses unto the whole of humanity, and the Prophet and the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becomes witness over you. Now that was the purpose of the founding of this ummah. Whenever you found a party, first of all you fix the aims and objects. What are the aims and objects of the party? If you are founding an anjuman, a society, what for? You have to lay down, put down in black and white, these are the aims and objects. What for this big anjuman, this big society, this big ummah, ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why has it been founded? What were the aims and objects? The aims and objects. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. And in other words, the same thing. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ. Now you have become the best ummah. You are qualified. You have qualified for this position of the best ummah that has been created, that has been raised for the mankind, whole of mankind. أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. What does it mean? Other people live for themselves, for their nations, for their countries. You have to live for the whole of mankind, for the benefit of the whole of mankind, to convey the message of Allah to the whole of mankind, to try to save the whole of the mankind from the fire of hell in the hereafter. That is the mission for which you have to live. You have to live for others. Other people live for themselves, for their own benefits, for their own welfare. But you have to work, you have to live, and you have to die for the sake of the whole of the humanity, to save them from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَعْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. The same thing. You have to enjoin whatever is good, whatever is correct. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. And you have to forbid from whatever is wrong, whatever is unjust. وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. And keep faith in Allah. Have tawakkul on Allah. Have confidence on him. And you have faith in him. وَلَوْ آمَنَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. And if the people of the book had also believed, it was much better for them. They would have saved themselves on the day of judgment. مِنْهُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. There are some among them who have the iman. A few actually, they embrace Islam also. There are in them maybe potentially mu'mins who could have accepted and embraced Islam afterwards. مِنْهُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَأَكْثَرُهُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. But you know, the majority of them, they are the of the rebellious nature. They are the transgressors. لَنْ يَضُرُّوكُمْ إِلَّا أَذًى. O Muslim, don't fear them. They won't be able to harm you except some timely, temporary and trifly hurt. لَنْ يَضُرُّوكُمْ إِلَّا أَذًى. وَنْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ يُوَلُّوكُمُ الْأَدْبَارِ. And if they dare to go to war against you, to come in the battlefield against you, they are sure to show you their backs. They will turn their backs and run away. ثُمَّ لَا يُنْصَرُونَ. And then they will not be helped from any quarter.